lights out.
How are you feeling?
Oh, okay. Starting to feel like a barrel on legs.
You look fine. No one would ever guess.
Listen, I think I owe you an apology about Scott. I should have been honest.
I don't know what you feel you have to keep secrets from me. I thought we were a team.
Hey, we are. I don't know. I just couldn't risk anything messing up this deal. To be honest, nothing's changed. I have to reach payroll in a few days, and I still have to sell somebody.
Yeah, well, it's transfer deadline day tomorrow.
Yeah, I know, but I have to try. I need the money, Ray.
Look, Linda, you do what you've got to do. Don't expect any help from me. Any player you get decent money for, I can't afford to lose. Especially now Scott's out the picture.
Morning, Sandra.
This just came for you by courier. And there's Mr. Sawyer waiting for you in your office.
Mrs. Block.
Hello.
Robert Sawyer, Environmental Health Officer, Harchester Council. I see you've got our letter about the Barons.
Sandra, go down to the changing room and tell Ray Wyatt I need him and all the first team in the boardroom in half an hour.
What about training?
Training will have to wait. This is an emergency. When you've done that, contact all the players' wives and ask them to be there as well, okay?
If they ask why?
I'll explain when they get there.
So you got any idea what this is about, Gaffer?
No.
I've just missed my aromatherapy, so it better be good.
Hello, everybody. I've asked you to come in today because I want you to hear this news directly from me, so there's no panic or confusion. Harchester County Council have contacted me this morning. This is Mr. Sawyer. He's from the Environmental Health Department. Now, he's warned me that according to this month's tests, the methane gas level at the Barents has risen to an unacceptable level.
What do they mean, unacceptable?
I'm afraid you're all going to have to vacate the Barons immediately.
Oh, fantastic.
I do realise that the club's contractually obliged to house most of you, but until we really know what's happening with the Barons, we'll have to accommodate you at the Grange.
Oh, well, the honeymoon suite at the Grange ain't too bad.
No, it won't be the honeymoon suite, Tash. It'll be strictly standard rooms for everyone, I'm afraid.
So what about our possessions?
Well, they want us to evacuate at the end of today, so take what you need, Lizzie. I know that you'll all have questions about safety, but Mr. Sawyer will be able to help you out as best he can. Excuse me. I'm sorry.
Hang on. How are you?
Mr. Sawyer, how long before we can move back into our homes?
Mrs. Block? Excuse me, Mrs. Block.
Sounds like me after 8 pints in a curry. Look.
Eddie, what are you doing in here?
I'd like a transfer, please. I'll go anywhere, I don't really care. You know, Finland's probably a good offer because the gaffer said he had a loan fix there for me, so.
Have you, talked to your agent?
Not yet, no.
Well, you get onto him and I'll make a few calls and you do know if this happens. It's got to happen within the next 24 hours.
Yeah. As soon as a bit, I just want to be away from this place, you know? Look, Mrs. Block, have you ever thought someone was the one? You know, you've sort of been that much in love with someone and they've just, sort of turned around and kicked you in the teeth.
I think we've all been there.
Yeah. You know, I just feel so stupid, you know?
Well, you may not realise it, but, actually, you might have just saved my bacon.
What?
Never mind. Well, I'll have a word with Ray and sort it out and see what we can do then, yeah?
Okay, thanks, Mrs. Block, for your help, alright? Thanks.
Good morning.
Morning.
Can I help you?
I'm looking for Jamie Parker.
Well, he's in a meeting at the moment. Do you want me to take a message?
Oh, it's alright. I'll wait.
Okay.
Can't prepare for a game if we're all cooped up in hotel rooms. Let's just rent somewhere.
We can't. That's exactly what Linda Block wants us to do.
I just want somewhere of our own.
Yeah, and that'd be nice.
I just don't see why we should pay for it. Not when your contract says we don't have to.
If I can't have the honeymoon suite, I'm not interested. I've got an image to keep, you know.
Will you get off the phone for 5 minutes? This is a crisis.
The last time this happened, my back was not right for a week.
Well, look, I don't want you to sleep in a chair. Maybe we could ask for separate rooms this time.
Oh, and have everyone suspect we're not married. Be sensible. Perhaps you could visit your family again for a few days.
All right, listen up. I know it's been a bit traumatic for everyone, but we've got a big game at the weekend, so we need to train. I'm afraid I'll have to leave the moving to the ladies. Sorry. Come on, lads.
Leave the women to cope. Typical.
What's up, Siobhan?
Andy wants me to go back to Ireland until this thing is sorted out. It's difficult.
Sharing a room, I can imagine.
Was going back to Ireland such a bad idea?
My family don't want to see me. And last time I went back, my mother called me a whore.
Does Monday know about this?
How can I tell him that because I married him, my family think I'm worse than dirt?
Gaff! Gaff! Listen, I just thought I'd let you know I've asked in the block for a transfer. A couple of weeks ago, Ella said that was the best thing for you and for us. The way you played against Arsenal, you knew all that time to play for, didn't you? You've always got something to play for. If you could perform like that week in, week out, you'd be a hell of a player. Look, Linda Block's bound to go for your transfer. She needs the money. I know we've had our differences, but I miss you. You are daft as a brush, but you brighten this place up.
Cheers, Gaff. Do you want to make a quick phone call to my agent?
OK. No more than 5 minutes, though, all right?
Thanks a lot, man.
Breakfast rates on each of the rooms.
And what about our other meals?
Well, you'll have to be responsible for all other expenses.
Well, that's not fair. If we were at home, we could afford to feed our families for half the price of a hotel meal.
Fine. We'll come to some arrangement, Lizzie.
And I still don't see why the guy from the council wouldn't let us know how long this will be for.
Because he said it's impossible to tell at this stage, we still need to do more tests.
Well, I'm sorry, but some of us have got families. We can't live like this. When are you going to let me try and find another house?
What? It's a bit early to discount the balance yet.
Linda, I'm not trying to tell you how to do your job.
Good morning.
But these are Premiership footballers. You can't expect them to play well if they don't even know where they're living.
Sorry to interrupt. It's just time for you on 19.
Right. I'm sorry, Lizzie. I have to take this call.
Ring through, Sandra.
It's my birthday.
You're not allowed to cry on birthdays till the big 3-0, and you look about 13.
20. I thought at least one of my family might phone me or send a card. I don't belong here. Now it feels like I don't belong there anymore either.
Oh, come here. Oh, this is all my fault. I should never have got you involved.
I think I can last 2 years, Tash.
Well, if you really can't, then walk away. This is not your problem. It's Mondays, my dad's, and the club's. You don't need to sacrifice yourself for them.
We've taken their money.
Listen, you've already earned the money. Now, come on, let's get some slap out of those red eyes. So once we're checked into the Grange, I'm going to show you the best birthday you've ever had. Come here.
To you boys, well done.
Wait, I've heard you ask for a transfer, mate.
Yeah, what do you care?
Of course I care, mate. Everybody does, right? Nobody wants to see you get hurt like that, did they?
Yeah, it must be upsetting for everyone, eh?
Look, man, just tell them you change your mind, all right? Don't go.
Right, so we go straight home, pack up our stuff as soon as we can, and then we're off, okay? Oh, babe, listen, don't hang around because I need your muscles at home, okay?
Jamie!
Siobhan, I'll be back to help you as soon as I can, okay?
Fine. See you later.
Mr. Parker, can I have a word? Outside.
You owe Mr. MacReady £48,000, and I'm here to collect it.
Look, I just need a bit more time.
No, you look. You took your bets in good faith, but you've been very silly, haven't you? We know you've been placing bets all over the place. And now you've lost your Porsche.
You what?
Oh, yeah. You've had that. Your pawnbroker sold it. So, I'll see you 7 o'clock tonight. We prefer cash. Right.
Are you threatening me?
I'll see you this evening.
At the hotel.
You can't leave him behind. He'll starve to death.
You just have to take him with you to your grandpa's, okay?
But I don't want to go to grandpa's. I want to stay here.
Well, you can't, Jake. We've been through this.
This is a joke.
Let's just call some estate agents.
No. The club's paying for accommodation and that's that. You should have a booking for a Mr. and Mrs. Conlon.
Excuse me. It should be under Wyatt.
There's actually a question mark by your booking. Was it two rooms you wanted?
It's just the one room, thank you very much.
Okay.
1 week in the Grange and they'll be at each other's throats.
That's exactly why I'm not staying there. Got myself the keys to a nice little loft. Belongs to a friend of mine.
Female?
Fairy.
Linda's bottle must be going.
Must be, if she's desperate enough to try and sell Eddie.
It doesn't have to be like this, you know. And the players have got to know.
I don't think I should start spreading the word. Don't you?
Make it clear that there is somebody who is willing and capable of solving the problems that Linda can't handle.
Right.
If she's as desperate as I think she is, then, it'll be game over pretty soon.
I'll see you later. Yeah.
Hello, mate, it's Jamie.
Eh?
Yeah, but I just want a couple of grand on tiny... But why? I've never let you down, have I? Oh, right. So MacReady's warned you off me, has he? Great. Hello? Pete?
You lost it by now. Don't tell me you didn't recognise him. Afraid not.
Siobhan, it's okay. I've already checked him.
Oh, look, there it is, under Parker. P-A-R-K-E-R. Do you need glasses or something, love?
Just the one room, then.
That's what was arranged for us.
Shame. One of us is going to have a bad back.
No, I know exactly what's in those cases. So if I see your sister in the newspaper in one of my talks, I'll know where to come.
Maybe I can arrange some... Siobhan!
Monday. Take it easy on her. She's having a bad time, right?
I know.
Yeah? And did you know it was her birthday and no one's done anything about it?
Her birthday? But there were no cards.
And why do you think that is?
Is there a problem back home? With her family?
Yeah, they're treating her like dirt.
But why?
Why do you think?
What can I do to help?
You could start by treating her right. Maybe buying her a present?
You gonna stare at that thing all day?
Nothing better to do, bruv. So why's everyone suddenly taking a big interest in me, then?
Because we're worried about you. Eddie, you gotta get out. You gotta get something else into your head apart from birds. What you need is something to help you get over her. I mean, you can't take drugs, you can't really drink.
So what have you got in mind then, Joe?
Come and have a punt with me.
What?
You need a buzz to help you forget about your problems. I mean, that's exactly what I do. Listen, we've all had bad times.
Yeah, well, not like this, you ain't, mate.
Oh, come on! You can't let that bird get the better of you. You got to get out of it. You can't just sit here and suffer.
No, we've tried that.
Well, and Block's not playing ball?
Nope. She said she'll put us up here until after the borough game. But then we either have to pay for this ourselves or we go and find a place of our own.
Could you have word for us, Skip?
Yeah, well, it's a bit difficult, lads. I can see where you're coming from, but, I mean, you haven't really got a leg to stand on. Contracts don't cover accommodation, do they?
Yeah, but we all play for the same team, though.
It doesn't matter if it's in our contract or not. She can't even pay our wages, let alone shell out for hotels. There's only one hope now, boys. New management.
You're right, ain't you? It's like you're sitting there, I need something else going on in my head. You know, but I never thought I could get this unhappy. And you reckon this will go take my mind off things, yeah?
Oh, guaranteed cure for all blues.
All right. You're on, bruv.
Brilliant.
Don't matter if I lose, does it, eh? Only way's up for me.
Yep. Mate, you're gonna love this.
Let's hope, eh?
No go. FC Jazz still want him on loan, but I don't think they've got the money to buy.
So, what do we do?
I don't know. I mean, I'm not exactly selling Louis Figo, am I? Anyway, I don't see why Eddie wants to move abroad. He loves it here.
It's quite simple. He's had his heart broken. Anyway, it's not just Eddie in this equation, is it?
Well, I've had an inquiry from Alan Smith at Palace.
How much?
It'd probably go to a million. But he ain't offering the wages, and Eddie won't take a drop.
You don't know that. He's desperate to get away. Now phone him, Jeff.
It's just so frustrating. We've covered Scott's injury, and Danny's having a blinder. Eddie at Winbeck has been a revelation, and now he decides he wants to do a runner.
It's not how I would have wanted it. We'll have to bring Orley in to replace Eddie for the Middlesbrough game. He's the only other left-sided player we've got.
Yeah. But Gaffer, you've done brilliant. Fourth with three games to go. We can get some help from upstairs. I think we can make this third spot.
Champions League, here we come, eh?
Yeah, but you don't need all this aggro.
Thanks. I've left messages at the hotel and on his mobile.
So where is he?
No one's seen him.
I need the deal, Jeff.
I see that. But what goes on inside Eddie's head is one of life's unsolved mysteries. Oh, and by the way, don't fancy your chances against Middlesbrough on Saturday. Mood your players are in.
Most people would be happy for the sort of luxury they're getting at the Grange.
But they're footballers, Linda. They need routine.
My heart bleeds. Concentrate on Eddie, Jeff. Running out of time.
Are you in love with your watch or something?
I'm just keen to make it for 120.
What, so how are we going to play it in, bruv?
Why? We'll start small. Lay 1 and 2k bets on every bookie along the rails. If we win, we'll play in the big league.
Oh, nice one, bruv. Nice one. Hey!
meaning to ask you, you couldn't sub me a little grand, could you? I'm skint to the side.
No problems, brother, hold on to that.
Is that right?
Yes, mate. After all, you got the brains, I got the dough, and the looks. Yeah. Have a good one, mate. Tidy Ted, tidy Ted.
£1,000 with Tidy Ted.
Thank you very much.
£2,000 with Tidy Ted. Thank you very much. Tidy Ted.
Come and have another glass. You'll soon feel better.
It's not going to help.
Always works for me.
I just wish they could see it my way, you know.
There's families for you, ain't it? If they're not arguing, they're crying. Now, come on, girl. Happy birthday.
Cheers.
Right. This is it. I'll tell you something, brother. I never thought it'd be this exciting, you know what I mean? Oh, we're lining up.
Go on, Ted, go on! Go on, my son!
Well, that's a good taste there, boy.
Come on. Go on, Ted! Stick it in, Ted, go on! He's doing it, go on, Ted!
Well done, that's perfect, thanks.
Happy birthday to you! Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Siobhan. Happy birthday to you.
Oh, thank you so much, all of you. This is really great.
Can we get a break of candles out then?
Yeah.
Come on.
One last one, come on.
Yay!
So anyway, you still right pressure under Tony, do you? Even after all this business with Didier?
He was new to the game last season, mate. I mean, what this club needs is someone with deep pockets and long arms.
Yeah, but Tony, he just wants his club as a trophy.
Mate, he loves the club, all right? That's why he stands up to Linda Block. And you've got to admit, mate, she's out of her depth now. If he doesn't grab us, mate, he's going to grab someone else's club. Do you know what I mean?
Kick? I'll get yours.
Yes! Thank you, you beauty! Oh, see, what did I tell you, mate? Always trust a man that knows. Still worried about that bird now?
Nah, forget her, bruv, this feels great!
Oh, it gets better.
So any more tips in, boy, or what?
Yeah. Yellow card. He's at 11-4 right now, but Ed, we've got to get really serious about this. We'll put everything we got on that nag and we'll enlarge, OK?
Everything, yeah?
Yeah.
Come on, my son.
I don't know, I'm getting a bit worried. His phone has been off for hours.
He'll be out enjoying himself.
That's men for you. I'd say he'd be back ages ago. I think I'm going to go back to the room and try ringing around. Do you mind?
Go for it.
Sure.
Hey, yeah, and if you see my man on your travels, tell me about it.
OK, see ya.
Thanks.
See you, Lizzie. See you later. So it is Monday, by the way.
Haven't a clue. He went off in half hours ago. Oh. Manny.
Sorry to interrupt. I just think about ringing the kids.
Oh, I suppose we should. Make sure they haven't killed your parents. You think I'm joking?
No.
Happy birthday.
Thanks. Thanks.
See ya.
For another glass of champagne, please.
Sure.
Yes. Alan Smith confirmed. Any luck at your end?
What's the offer?
£1 million.
Good. So that just leaves the problem of wages. I'm sure they won't pay the amount he's on here.
Yeah, well, Eddie said he wanted out.
Now's his chance. Phone him. Sandra, can you draft a letter of acceptance for the Palace offer? I want confirmation of the transfer today.
Go on, Yelica, go on!
Oh, who's this?
What have you got that one for?
I'm sorry, bro, I'm sorry.
Yeah, hello?
Where the hell have you been?
Yeah, well, I've been busy, ain't I?
Oh, really? Well, so have we.
You got an offer, yeah? Somewhere warm, I hope?
Not exactly. But it's a really good deal.
Been offered a million.
Yeah, that's nice.
By Alan Smith.
Crystal Palace, that's not abroad, though, Jeff.
Now, listen here, son.
I've been at it all day trying to sort something out to make you happy.
I'm not going to London. Maria's in London. I told you, didn't I? Yeah, I'm not going over 100 miles of that place. So forget it. It's abroad or nothing. Yeah, bye.
Come on!
You've only gone and done it.
You're a genius, Bob. How much are you up now? How much?
20k. Which we are going to put on Zoe's blush.
Whoa, 20k?
No, I'm telling you, man, Zoe's blush is our horse. It's at 11 to 2, we got to go for it. This is going to be the win of the century.
Yeah, I'd love all of it.
All of it. Do you believe?
Yeah, total belief, bro.
Well, then go and do it, mate.
No is not good enough. We've got payday at the end of this week. I need the money. Isn't there somewhere else we can try?
There is one option. Trabzonspor, a Turkish side. They definitely rate Eddie.
What, you've talked to them?
Briefly. They could raise the million and match his wages.
So what's the problem?
Nothing. It's just Eddie won't like it there. There's a totally different culture to their football. They sacrifice a goat at the beginning of every season.
Well, he'll cope. Listen, Eddie's going to Turkey whether he likes it or not. Close the deal, Jeff.
Right. That's enough fun and games for you kiddies. Now you get to watch a real master at work.
Oh, you're not going to try your luck over there, are you?
And why not?
Well, because by the looks of her, mate, she's plastered.
Yeah, exactly. Saves on expense. Look, boys, don't lose any sleep over it. The marriage smelled like a phony to me from the start. Now watch and learn.
Hey! They left you all alone on your birthday. It's not very nice, is it? So, where's Mundo?
I don't know.
Well, don't you worry about it. Mundo, you kill him if he comes in and sees us.
Waiter, champagne.
Siobhan, thank you for everything. Best wishes. Monday.
Look, it's ringing. What should I say?
Say it's Prash. Just keep him on the line long enough for me to get rid of her, all right?
All right. Hello? It's Mr. Dattani here.
So let's go for a bite to eat, yeah?
Oh, no, I should wait for Monday.
Oh, no. It'd be much better the two of us. And anyway, we both know that you don't need anyone's permission, right?
Oh, I'm not sure.
Come on.
Yeah. Maybe we could.
They're getting flinched now.
No, I've definitely had...
Rubbish! Come on, live a little, yeah?
Mr. Fletcher. There's a call for you. Mr. Dattani in reception.
All right, okay. All right. Sorry, sweetheart, there's a bit of business. I'll be right back, all right? Stay exactly as you are.
Siobhan, what are you playing at?
Danny. Danny, boy. Have a drink.
No, come on,
we'll
put it down. No, put it down. Come on, let's leave. Come on.
Hello? Hello?
Dead.
You sure it's for me?
Yeah, Mr. Prashant Dattani.
Come on, birthday girl.
Rose. Happy birthday. Oh, it's my birthday.
Whoa, whoa, that's not it, that's not it.
Oh, you can't do that. There's people in there. You can't.
You know, you're a good boy, Danny Rosslyn.
Yes, I'm a very good boy now.
You
come
are.
On.
An excellent boy, I'd go as far as...
Look, that's it. Whoa, stay there, all right? Stay. Come on, get up.
Ooh, you've got a good way of getting to know a girl.
What the hell do you think you're doing? Get away from her!
Monday, I was just trying to help her, all right?
You are drunk!
That hurts!
Oi, don't be so heavy.
What does it to do with you?
Stop it! Stop it, will you? Both of you, just leave me alone!
For the money.
Could you take that?
And keep a change. Like you, sell out the kids, they grow up, remember.
Tash!
Tash!
For the money!
What's the matter with a stupid cow?
You probably have Cher again, haven't you, eh? You ain't doing, boy.
She's probably stuck her toes together with that lip gloss.
Toe gloss.
Whatever. Whatever.
Can you hold on to that for us?
Money.
Danger. So dangerous about a gate.
There's a padlock.
Hang on, bruv. There's
a padlock.
Whoa, whoa. Jamie, bruv.
Come down.
Get off.
Come down. Come down.
It's shut.
Well, I know that, Ed.
It's a padlock on the gate. It's shut.
Oh, we're supposed to be staying at the hotel, aren't we?
We're homeless.
We're homeless.
Homeless.
Eddie, what's the time? What time is it? What time?
7:30, maybe-ish.
About?
7.
Oh, no. I'm supposed to meet somebody.
Where are you going?
Still not picking up.
No. Right. He's got 5 minutes.
Can I have my key, please?
Of course.
Thank you.
Linda.
Any news?
Apparently, Eddie and Jamie went out together hours ago.
Oh, that's great news.
Come on. How about I buy you a drink while we wait for the missing link?
I just don't see why you had to be so cruel to him.
You were all over him.
Yeah. What's it to you?
You were making a spectacle of yourself.
He was helping me back here. And anyway, what if I had flirted with him? You were with Lola. For all I know, you still are.
The last I heard, she was in Paris.
You can't seriously expect me to stay celibate for the next 2 years. I'm a human.
You're lucky you didn't smash your face in, mate.
I'm sick of being the one who's always stuck in the middle.
Yeah, well, you stick your nose in.
Like I'm gonna leave it to Fletcher Letts to look after.
Suppose not. But that's best left well alone, though, isn't it? Look, if you think I'm going to get caught up between Monday and Fletch...
Yeah, well, if you ask me, mate, Siobhan's too good for the both of them. I mean, Monday treats her like a housekeeper. He never takes her out or anything.
Look, if you're trying to tell me you got something going for her, I'll take a long, cold shower. If you haven't noticed, that girl's very much taken, mate.
So where's all the single ones, then, Hoops?
It's all a mystery to me, mate.
Do you think the people are bringing their drinks here?
No, but it's certainly working.
It feels good here, doesn't it?
Yeah, it does. To be honest, I think we needed a night off from the kids.
And the Barons. You know, if you think about it, nothing's gone right for us since we moved here.
Well, maybe. Even if this methane thing is cleared up. We shouldn't move back there.
What, move away from our workmates? Find somewhere with a bit more privacy.
Exactly. Do you remember our first night in a hotel?
What, the White Hart?
Yeah.
How could I forget? Do you remember that landlady?
Oh, Mrs. Hitler. I thought she was going to get us arrested for sleeping together before we were married.
Well, she was just jealous.
What?
Of us. We had something really special back then.
I remember.
Hi, this is Jamie Parker. Just because the phone's off doesn't mean you can't leave me some good news.
We've got it. Treb's on spore. Have confirmed.
What? Oh, Jeff, this is great. This is just what we need. We've got to find Eddie so we can reply tonight. We just need his signature.
Try him again.
It's difficult for me. I suppose I just feel responsible for you.
That's sweet. I have to be able to see who I like.
Just try not to pick one of my teammates.
Guess I can live with that.
Oh, I almost forgot. Happy birthday.
Oh, my God. This must have cost a fortune.
I wanted to get you something that mattered. I thought the emeralds would remind you of home.
I don't believe it. We got God knows how many thousands of pounds and we can't even get a cab. I don't know what your problem is, but I found it all quite refreshing, really. Hello, sweetheart.
Hey, sir.
Me and my friend, the drunk one, have won all the money.
Hello, mate. No one's been asking for me, have they?
I've only just started my shift, sir, but I'll check. I'm sorry, sir, there's no messages.
Oh.
Parksy! How about a little nightcap to celebrate the winning streak?
I will have a swift half, but I really do need to get upstairs and see the missus.
You, my friend, are a lucky banana. Come on in.
All right, who is it?
Room service.
I didn't order anything.
Could we step inside and have a little talk?
No, you can't.
Well, it's a bit embarrassing. It's about your husband.
Your old Bill. Has my Jamie had an accident?
No. No, it's nothing like that.
Huh? What the hell do you think you're doing?
Now, look. There's no need to get stupid about this. Your husband owes someone a great deal of money, and I'm here to collect. Now, we can do it the easy way or the hard way.
If you don't get out of here, I'm calling security. I'm done in, Jeff. Can't wait here for him all night. Look, I'm going to bed. We'll have to sort this out first thing in the morning, yeah?
Let me get them for you, sunshine.
I wouldn't leave just yet.
Bar steward, two bowls of your bestest champagne, please.
Eddie.
Hey, Jeffrey, how you doing, big man? Mrs. B. A vision of loveliness. Is she not a vision of loveliness, AJ?
Where have you been? Been trying to contact you all afternoon. We've cut you a dream deal.
You've been celebrating your move, Ellie.
Celebrating a win at the GG's. Who's moving?
To Trebzonspor.
Who's he?
Jeff's cut you a deal with the Turkish club.
Don't you answer your messages. We've got to sort out personal terms.
Turkey? What am I going to Turkey for? Huh? You guys need me here, fighting on the front line.
What a genius. I want a roll. My dad bread roll, barman.
You can't have that. It was a present.
Right, love. Now, where's the keys to your car?
You're not taking my car.
You really don't understand your old man at all, do you? He owes the best part of 50 grand.
I don't believe you.
Haven't you wondered where the Porsche's got to?
He's buying us a new one.
Rubbish. He's pawned it. Can't you see? Your husband's got a serious gambling problem. It's really very sad. Right. Let's go.
You're not taking... Ah! I can't afford to keep you, Eddie.
You can't afford to lose me, Mrs. Brock. With me, you're getting to Europe.
But you asked me for a transfer.
We win every game from now to the end of the season. And you want to know why? Because Eddie here is your lucky charm, Eddie, eh?
I'm afraid if the lad says no, there's not a lot we can do about it.
I give up. Have to excuse me, it's been a long day.
Right, I'm going to go and see my wife. I'll see you tomorrow. Good night, Jeff.
You made yourself a little animal. Don't hurt times.
Sorry, Jeff.
So you have any more home white tash?
No, then.
Look what I've got. Look! I got this for you. Babes. Babes, what's happened? Who did this to you?
They took my jewellery and my car. They said you owe money. Is it true?
Look, look, I've got their money. That's what I've been doing all day. We weren't owing them anything anymore. We're all right now, babes.
No, we're not.
Let the door go. It's over. They won't come back again. It's finished.
Yeah, you're right. It is. Me and you. Over.
Dream Team.
You doing, bruv?
I'm just taking a sub, you know, for the win.
You're nicking it, ain't you?
You want to sort yourself out, you mug!
Ed, what are you hiding? Show me.
It's nothing, I just slipped.
Did you do this?
I never touched her.
You must think I was born yesterday.
Dad!
Oh, now that, son, was no accident.